بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم صلى الله عليك يا سيدي ويا مولاي يا رسول الله صلى الله وسلم عليك يا سيدي ويا مولاي وابن مولاي يا أبا عبد الله يا رحمة الله الواسعة ويا باب نجاة الأمة ويا عبرة كل مؤمن ومؤمنة ما خاب من تمسك بكم وأمن من لجأ والتجأ إليكم يا ليتنا كنا معكم سادتي فنفوز فوزا عظيم عظم الله أجورنا وأجوركم بمصابنا لسيدنا ومولانا أبا عبد الله الحسين. The narration says, every time Abu Hamza al-Thamali, one of the companions of the fourth Imam, would walk into the presence of the Imam Zainul Abidin, most of the times he would find the Imam crying and weeping. One day, many years later, Abu Hamza al-Thamali tells the Imam, Ya Sayyidi ibn Rasulillah, Jadduka Amir al-Mu'mineen Qutil, Rasulullah Qutil, Ahlul Bayt Shuhada, all the companions, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Rasulullah, Fatimatu al-Zahra, the beloveds in the Ahlul Bayt have all died. Likewise, your father Aba Abdullah died. Many years ago, you still cry every single day. Ya Sayyidi, stop crying and cheer up and take the depression away from your life. Imam Zainul Abidin looks at Abu Hamza al-Thamali. He tells him, Ya Aba Hamza, Wallah, Kullama nazartu ila ammati Zainab, Waliha ula il atfal, Tadhakkartu firarahum, Min khaymatin ila khayma, Fi yawmi ashura. Ya Aba Hamza, every time I look at my aunt Zainab, every time I look at the children, I remember how their clothes was set on fire in the day of Ashura, and they would run from one tent to another. Brothers and sisters, after Aba Abdullah was martyred, the greatest tragedy is that they put the heads of those beloveds on spears and they raised them up high. Then Umar ibn Sa'd la'natullahi alayhi ordered the horsemen to sit on their horses and he said, Ya khayl Allah irkabi wa sadr al-Husayn raddi. O horsemen of Allah, he calls them the horsemen of Allah, ride your horses and stumble the chest of Aba Abdullah and his companions. They stumbled their chest. Then what happened is that they went and they put fire in the tents of Aba Abdullah. Uhruqu khiyam al-dhullam. Burn down the tents of those who did injustice, meaning the tents of Al-Muhammad. The narrations say that they even took the hijab away from Ahlul Bayt salamullahi alayhim. That is why Sayyidina wa Mawlana Imam Sahib al-Zaman on a night like tonight doesn't wear his turban. And he says to the believers, I do not know how you stand watching your woman in dignity and wearing their hijab while the children and the women of Al-Muhammad are hijabless, while you stay in the comfort of your homes and the household of Al-Muhammad is homeless, while you eat the food and you drink the water, and the Al-Muhammad and the Ahlul Bayt have no water to drink and no food to eat. One narration says that one of the little girls, her clothes was on fire. She was running from one tent to another. One of the narrators says, I was there just writing history and seeing what takes place. I ran towards this child to help her take out the fire from her clothes. She said to me, Ya Rajul, Ya Abdullah, Hal sami'ta bil Quran? She said to him, have you recited the Quran? He said, yes. He said, هَلْ قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنِ? Have you actually read the Qur'an? He said, yes. She said, أَلْ أَنْتَ مَعَنَا أَمْ عَلَيْنَا? Are you with us or against us? He said, لَا مَعَكُمْ وَلَا عَلَيْكُمْ. I am neither with you or against you. She said, then have you read the verse, وَأَمَّا الْيَتِيمَ فَلَا تَقْهَرْ? Do not disturb and break the heart of the orphan. He said, yes, I have. She said then to him, أَنَا يَتِيمَةُ الْحُسَيْنِ? I am the orphan of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. The narration say that they gathered the women and children. They took out the whips and they began to whip the Ahlul Bayt of Rasulullah. At that time, Zainab looked towards her father, Ali ibn Abi Talib, and she told him, oh father, oh the lion of Allah, oh the lion of Rasulullah, oh the lion of Islam, oh the commander of the faithful, oh the one that paid both of his allegiance, oh the one that fought next to Rasulullah with two swords and two spears, oh the one that was assisted and protected by Jibra'il and Mikael. Come and look at your daughter Zainab and your grandchildren and see what state they're living in, and see that your daughter Zainab is being beaten by the whips of your enemies. Then she looked at the Euphrates towards Abbas, her brother. She said to him, Abbas, ya Qamar bani Hashim, man tali jibtni ubidak ya khoya, ركبتني بس ما رحت عني وعفتني عقبك بني ميا ولتني تعال اقعد وشوف متني صياد زجر الورمتني She said, Abbas, when I was coming, you were the one that put me on the back of my horse. You were the one that put me on the back of my camel. You were the one that protected me. You were the one that honored me. Now stand up and see what is happening to your sister Zainab, for they have taken the hijab away from her. They have been whipping her. Come and take a look at the chest of your sister Zainab. Let them remind you of the chest of Fatima. Take a look at the face of your sister Zainab. Let it remind you of the cheeks of Fatima. Then she looked at the dead body and the chopped off body of Abu Abdullah. She said, Ya Abu Abdullah, I have not been given a choice to stay with you. They're making me go towards Damascus. And if they give me the choice, لو خيروني في المقام لبقيت عندك يا سيدي. Let's go, نسيت الأخوة. السلام عليكم يا أهل بيت النبوة ومعدن الرسالة ومختلف الملائكة. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. سيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون. والعاقبة للمتقين والنار للعاصين. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.